time, baby. First time. First time for everything. Yes, this is the go home shows. You know, the shows before the pay-per-view. Really, you know, psych you up.
And I don't believe it. I actually watched this live for the first time in years.
Impressive. I can't remember the last time I watched a live Raw. The one where Jericho came back, I guess.
Possibly. So, we opened up the show with Brock.
He's here. They paid him enough.
He was. And he's with Paul as well.
Which, well, yeah, of course, because Paul has to do all the talking. Oh, yeah, yeah. You know the promo you're going to get from Paul Heyman. He did all right. And then, what, randomly Vince McMahon came out?
Yeah. Yeah, Vinny made a rare appearance. And then Finn came out and said, look, I know you don't believe in me and you just think I'm going to get my ass kicked at the Royal Rumble. And then for no reason whatsoever, Braun then came out.
Yeah.
He went on about something or other. And then Finn turned around and said, well, with all due respect, Braun, in future, stay the hell out of my business.
Oh, tough words there.
And then, Finn went on a bit of a tirade about, like, you know, oh, you don't believe in me, but let's remember one of the greatest stories ever told. David versus Goliath.
Yeah.
And then, of course, this then gave Vince a brilliant, oh, well, how about we have a David versus Goliath match tonight? We can have Finn Balor versus Braun Strowman.
Yeah, and that was actually the first match of the evening.
And, of course, Brock could stay at ringside if he so chose to.
Yeah, he went to walk away, and then he was like, hey, you know what, I will stick around for this one. Which basically meant interference, because I was like, yep, he's interfering in this one. So the match was your typical big man, little man match. You know, Braun had most of the offense. Finn had his, you know, comeback moments every now and then.
Yeah. Although, I will say, the match should have ended a lot quicker than when it actually did.
It should have. I know the bit you're referring to.
Now, probably about halfway through the match, Braun decided he'd had enough. He literally threw Finn at Brock.
Yeah.
So then Brock being Brock, he caught him. And then he suplexed him.
Yes. I watched this and I was like, the ref saw that. Why has he not rang the bell?
Exactly.
For the DQ.
Well, that then got me thinking, you know, oh, we've got some stupid BS going on there. Just going, that's no DQ. We just forgot to tell you. But no, about 5 minutes later, the match did end with a disqualification.
Oh, God. Oh, yeah, because what? Brock came in the ring and beat both of them up.
Yeah, but he hit Finn first. Mm. So Finn Balor won by DQ.
For God's sake.
So, yeah, just turn up, Brock. It's nice to know you can turn up for work when you can be asked.
Must have been in a city he's willing to go to.
Yeah.
It might have been Oklahoma.
It was. It was in Oklahoma.
Daryl.
Oh, boy. Where do we start with this hot steaming pile of garbage?
Well, it was supposed to be Lashley's Intercontinental title celebration.
Yeah. But then it was interrupted by Apollo Crews. And then Leo Rush came up with the ingenious idea. You don't deserve to face Bobby Lashley. Now, you got to earn it. So you can beat him in a pose-off.
A pose-off. My God.
Then you can fight him.
Well, yeah, it wasn't pretty.
No.
In fact, I think towards the end of it, Rush got annoyed and like attacked Apollo Crews.
And then Apollo took him out.
And I was like, you know what? They're going to go to a commercial break. It's going to come back. And they're going to go, yeah, it's a match now.
And that's exactly what happened.
Yeah. In that order. Non-title, obviously.
Hmm. I'll give him his dues. Apollo Crews gave it a good go.
I wanted him to win. I really did.
But you always knew how this was going to end. And I've got to add as well, whilst I remember as well, is it me, or has Bobby Lashley shaved his eyebrows off?
I think he has. I don't know why.
Why? We, nobody knows. Yeah, but unfortunately we were all left disappointed. Bob picked up the victory.
Yeah, there was more distraction there from Leo Rush. I think he grabbed his leg or something.
Yeah,
and then
so.
Lashley hit the spear.
Ooh.
Yeah, he didn't finish it with the Dominator. He speared him.
Mm. Oh, and then I think at some point did Seth Rollins make an appearance after the match?
Yeah, I think he might have walked past someone.
Yeah, because he was in action next.
Ooh.
He was fighting the Scottish Psychopath.
Oh, it's Psychopath this week.
Yeah, something like that.
They change it every week.
Oh, tell me about it. It's hard to keep up with it.
I'll be honest with you, I actually enjoyed this one.
It was good. Oh, yeah, because let's not forget, before the match started, Seth Rollins done a big promo about the Royal Rumble, and he was also paying homage to Martin Luther King.
Yeah.
Conveniently on Martin Luther King Day.
Yeah, it was.
So, yeah. Seth's going, yeah, I'm going in a rumble. I'm going to win it. Maybe.
Maybe. Who knows? Could happen. He's up there.
Yeah. So, enjoyable match, though, for once.
Yeah. This is might just be the purist in me, but this is one of those rare matches where there was no interference, no dirty tactics. We had a clean win.
We did.
And I like this pinfall. I did. Mm.
Fine.
Oh, I'm trying to remember what the sequence was. I don't actually remember how it came about, but he did the pinfall where he rolled him up and then he jumped on top of him. So he couldn't get the shoulders up.
Yeah.
Wasn't the normal roll-up, but one of those stacked roll-ups.
Yes.
And he quickly got out of there.
Hmm.
He was like, no way, I'm not getting Claymore kicked. I'm out.
So, and we had a couple of people randomly declare they're going to be in the Royal Rumble.
Oh.
So, you know, Tyus is in the Rumble.
That was a funny one. Cause
hopefully he doesn't trip over his own feet again.
Because he was doing some promo about him being Rumble and someone walked past him. He was like, hey man, you just gonna interrupt me. I'm doing a promo.
Then like Bane said he's gonna be in the Rumble.
Yes, I'm gonna be in the Rumble.
So nobody cares about that.
No, he'll probably just get thrown out. It'll be fine.
So pointless tag team match number one.
Oh, God.
We've got the Lucha House Party. Now, straight away, don't panic. They're not fighting the Revival.
Oh,
again.
Thank God.
Ah, they're fighting Jinder and the Sings.
I paid so very little attention to this match. It's not even funny.
All I know is Jinder lost.
He did. I don't think it was him that got pinned, because I remember him flipping off on the outside of the ring.
No. Gran Metalik picked up the victory.
Yeah, that's right.
Using the Tilt-A-Whirl backbreaker.
Yeah, on one of the Singh brothers.
Yeah.
We don't know which one.
Yeah.
I mean, I like the Lucha House Party. They're good, but for God's sake, they need to get rid of Jinder. He's just nothing.
Now it's time to kick it up a notch. We had Elias in the ring.
Yeah, he was doing a concert. He had a new song.
But he was interrupted by Baron.
I like it. He finally called out Baron on his terrible dress sense. He was like, "You're not the authority anymore. What's with the ridiculous waistcoat?" Work on.
I don't think Baron even actually responded to it.
No. Something about his song being stupid.
Yeah. So, inevitably this turned into a match, and, you know, Elias has been on quite a roll recently. Getting a hell of a lot of popularity and everything. Doing a good job of it. So, what's the natural thing to do here? Let's have him lose a match.
But they did this same exact ending 2 weeks ago. Or 3 weeks ago. I can't remember how, but they did this match, what, 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, it was about that.
And it was the same thing.
Yeah. Baron picking up the victory at the end of days.
Yeah, just out of nowhere.
Was it Randy Orton out of nowhere?
No. Randy Orton out of nowhere is never out of nowhere. We always see it coming now.
So, we moved on to one of Sam's favourite parts of the week.
Woo!
It was time for a moment of bliss.
Everybody needs a moment of bliss.
And our guest this week was Nia Jax.
Oh, great.
So, they waffled on a bit. And then a load of the other women's division came out. And they got into a brawl for no reason whatsoever.
A big old brawl.
And then Alexa Zaytara said, "Wow, that was unexpected." And then Alexa declared, "She's back. She's been cleared. And she's entering the Women's Royal Rumble match."
That one I'm okay with, because we didn't know whether she was going to wrestle again.
And then for no reason whatsoever, she got interrupted by Lacey Evans.
Oh, the lady of NXT.
And the lady of NXT is now in the Rumble,
That's apparently good. I like her. She's a decent wrestler. She's got a good right hand.
You know what? When they decide they're done with it, I wouldn't be surprised if they team her up with the Revival.
Oh,
fists.
No, that would not work. PG environment, man. We can't be doing that.
Oh, man. I was looking forward to this one.
Oh, no.
It was time for some tag team action. And it was time for Heavy Machinery to get in on the action.
Two fat guys in a pod.
Stakes and weights, baby. And they were facing off against the Ascension. So you knew how this one was going to end.
Not well for the Ascension.
Right.
Did they even get a move in? I don't think they did.
Tucky and Dozovich getting the job done.
Oh, man. Yeah, they beat him up with the compactor.
Mm-hmm.
Which I got to say, if you're on the receiving end of, I feel sorry for you.
Oh, don't forget, Dozovich did the caterpillar elbow drop.
Yeah, that was pretty funny.
Well, it's probably more for like Corey to say, "Oh, I've never seen a caterpillar move like that."
He's just ripping off Scotty too high.
Pretty much.
But it's a fat man doing it instead of a thin man.
There you go. Heavy Machinery with the victory.
But well, we must stress, at this point, they are not on Raw or SmackDown yet. They're still free agents.
So, talking of tag team action, we're going to keep the ball rolling on this one. We've got Raw tag team title match, which probably means we're not getting a tag title match at the Rumble.
It's on the pre-show, I think.
So, we got the ridiculously confusing tag team champions face off against Jim Cornette's favourite team of The Revival.
And for reasons we don't know why, The Revival wanted another referee.
Yeah.
Kurt Hawkins was randomly walking through the building, and Vince McMahon went, You'll do. You can be the ref. You ain't have another match. You're losing streaks too long. So Kurt Hawkins was the ref for this match.
Yeah.
And he actually did a good job.
Yeah, I was going to say, to be fair, I didn't pay this match an awful lot of attention. I'm just bored of Rude and Gable.
Yeah, well, you'll be happy to know the greatest thing happened after the match was over.
I did hear about it.
Yeah, Rude and Gable retained.
Shock.
This time it was completely clean because Kurt Hawkins saw all of the cheating going on.
Oh.
And he didn't let any of it slide. The Revival started beating up Kurt Hawkins. And then Zack Ryder came out.
Yes!
The Edgeheads are back.
Yeah.
I hope.
Ryder's just got to grow his hair out a little bit.
Maybe get rid of the beard. Doesn't quite go. Not when he was with the Edgeheads. The whole gimmick was they were looking alike.
True.
Is this the return of the Edgeheads? We hope so.
So, you bored of tag team action yet?
Yeah.
Well, get comfy, folks. We've got another tag team match for the main event.
Oh, what hard, epic hitting match have we got here?
Got some women's tag team action.
Oh.
We've got the Hug and Boss Connection facing off against Ronda and her BFF, Natalya.
Well, I'm already bored. I paid a bit of attention to this match. It was okay.
Yeah, it wasn't bad.
Like, I thought maybe Bayley got a bit too much offense in on Ronda. I sort of had it in my mind that I knew where they were going with it. They got to make the challenger look strong.
Hmm.
But at the end of it, she didn't actually beat Ronda.
No, she beat Natalya.
Natalya tapped out. To the bank state.
Bank on that.
But can she do it to Ronda this Sunday?
Probably not.
Will it matter in the grand scheme of things?
Who knows?
And what about that painting? You know, the Scream. Was it actually fake? Apparently it was.
Okay.
And that's actually how we ended the show.
Yeah.
Team Hug and Boss celebrating. Yay. Getting ready for their tag team title match at the Elimination Chamber.
Mm.
Which is actually going to be in the Elimination Chamber.
Oh.
Which is just going to be a mess. Well, no, that's going to wrap it up for this edition of Raw. Didn't mind this one. This was okay.
No, it wasn't too bad for a go-home show. Normally, they're hot garbage.
This one was okay.
Yeah.
So, that's going to wrap it up. From your hosts, the master of the brain damage,
Martin,
and the one and only Sam H. We will see you on the next one.
Are you boss or...